Good afternoon. It's the 29th today. I'll just sort of share a story with you. When we got back yesterday, we finished our walk and we walked back, and you come through that gate over there. There's our car. And I had to get something out of the car, so I took a little while. And Lucy brought Marley up here to the tents. And she came back down, she said, "Austin, there's an animal in our tent." And I thought, "What?" She said, "There's growling and a load of shuffling and bumping about." So, thinking it was a fox or something, I went up to the tent. This had all been pulled out the ground. And believe it or not, when I opened the tent, this had happened. And there was a hound in there from one of the local farms. She just stood up, wagged her tail at me. And then I had to coax her out, and we took her to the owner. But she ate every single one of Marley's treats. Now, when I'm talking, you're probably looking at a month's worth. She'll be the best fed hound in the valley. God, can you believe it? Right, cheap Marley. Good morning. It is the 30th of December. Welcome back. We are back at our little river crossing on the way into Wasdale Head from the campsite. And today we're thinking of heading up Kirk Fell. But there ain't going to be much views, but to be honest, wherever you go today, we were spoilt the other day with that beautiful day. But the choice is wild camp tonight, and then spend New Year's Eve at the pub tomorrow, and then pack up and go home the next day, or wild camp at New Year's Eve, come off the mountain, and then pack up and drive home 320 miles, and I don't fancy that. So, while Lucy is making her way across there, poles out. Yeah. Welcome along today. And yeah, welcome along, and we'll see how this one goes. Right, I'll bring you back a bit later. Out the way, sheep, we're coming through. Marley wants to come through. The easiest way to clear sheep is to have a black and white collie on a lead. There you go. Okay, we've just gone round the side of Wasdale Head Inn, which is there. And we're not going to cross this beautiful little bridge, but instead we're heading up here. Hello, we have made our way out of Wasdale over there. You can see the road and the pub. We didn't turn right at the bridge. We carried on walking and we followed this wall up, and it leads us to Black Sail Pass, I think it's called. Beautiful. Beautiful clear water. There's Marley up there. Full of beans today. Right, we're still marching on. And we are heading up. What I thought was this was Black Sail Pass. That is Black Sail Pass up there. So that's where we're going to head when the track forks. We'll take the right. You can see the green line. That's the path going up. Marley's path finding as usual. Thank you. Okay, we're at 550 metres, and like I said, we're not going up Kirkfell, we're heading back down where Lucy's in the mist there, and we're just gonna camp near where there's a little bit of water supply. But it's too windy, too murky. What you're gonna see up there, pointless. So hopefully we'll get a bit of a view in the morning from where we'll camp. Again, hopefully you're not steaming up. Hopefully it's not steaming up. We've pitched, as you can see. Marley's down there, downstairs in the other end of the tent. Pretty warm, pretty windy, quite chilly. We're just gonna have a nice cup of coffee, but I'm going for the flash stuff. Look, an in cup. Good idea, eh? Right. The good thing is with these, it goes through quite quickly, so you don't have to worry about it going too cold. Well, here we are, just sat in the tent. It's a bit grim out there. Yeah, brilliant to get out on a wild camp. The last wild camp we had was a bit of a disaster because we were meant to meet up with Scott of Scott Free off YouTube, and this happened. Well, not the best start to this weekend. We were going to meet Scott at Bristol, pick him up and head off to the Black Mountains, but lo and behold, the RAV's broken down. I think the oil pump's gone. We're waiting for breakdown. We're at Lee Delamere Services, 20 miles from Bristol. Gutted. So it's good to get out, back out again, even though we can't really get out the tent. It's a bit drizzly, it's very murky, and it's windy as hell. It's about 6 degrees, 5 degrees at the moment, but it's about freezing with the wind chill, so your hands don't take any time at all to go numb. We've got Craig Charles on the radio. Marley's, say hello, Marley. Hello. Marley's comfy. Good boy. So we're just going to chill for a while.
Ready? There you go. Whoa, what have you got? You got cheap McDonald's food.
You love that, don't you?
It's like going through the drive-thru, that, isn't it, Marley? Doesn't mean you get cheap food at home.
Is that nice? Okay, for dinner tonight we're on the lightweight dehydrated stuff. I'm on satay chicken, Lucy's having vegetarian Thai rice. Very nice. Cool, traffic sounds terrible out there. Hey, it's not on this mountain. What you got in there, Luke?
That's vegetarian Thai rice.
Very nice. Not bad. Right, grand opening. Oh, that don't look bad.
Satay chicken.
So they go. That ain't bad. That's really good. I'm impressed with these because They're very lightweight, obviously, because they're dehydrated, and they're 600 calories each, which is a hell of a lot.
Wayfair
is
only
308. Yeah, they're good. Nice as well. Better than the goosefish. What was that? Someone left a comment on YouTube. That looked like Hungarian goosefish. Mm-hmm. I had to agree. Stay.
Whoa.
As you can see, the weather's not too good. Rain's come in. Wind's picked up. Fog. Ugh, it's awful. You can just spot Marley coming down. He's got a bit of a limp, hit his foot. He'll be all right in the morning. What a night, look. Yeah, windy, wet, murky. Visibility about 30 feet. So, let's get back in that tent and go to sleep. Good night, we'll see you in the morning. Good morning, mister. Hello, hold hands. How did you sleep, mate? Just turn that radio down. You slept well, didn't you? Hey? Well, oh, it's not looking that nice out there. Still pretty windy. Oh, good morning, everybody. Well, that wasn't a bad night after all, actually. Very windy, and we were on uneven ground because we couldn't find an even pitch, but that was good, wasn't it, Marley? Good morning. Hello, buddy. Good morning. So, we've just had a coffee. It's about 8 o'clock in the morning, and as you can see, it's just getting light. So, it is now New Year's Eve. Good morning again. Hello, Marley. Right, we're just packing up. It's still very, very windy. Not a bad view, though. Excuse the wind. Again, I can't do anything about it. Right, so, let's get this tent. Very much doubt you can hear this, but we're all packed up. That's where we were, and rather than heading up, we're heading back down to the campsite to our nice warm tent. So this way, Marley, come on. So let's see if there's any nice scenes on the way down. My god, is it still windy. Really has been a blustery evening. Fantastic though. Trouble is, he does that in the snow. Then he just goes. Come on, then, you. Let's go.
Did you ever?
Go on, David.
I've been playing games. We can try to hide it. It's all the same. I've been losing. One day at a time.
Hasn't been such a beautiful place. Just thought I'd mention something that I assume we all know about already. The white explorer Paul, Mark's twin brother Paul, passed away before Christmas, and I just wanted to say how very sad that news was, and I really feel for you, Mark, and I hope you can bear up, and I'm sure that it'll live on in your videos and in the outdoor adventures of the white explorer. So, all the best to you. What's that? Right. Here we are, back at the tent. Doesn't look like there's any wild animals broken in this time.
Right, that is us packed up and ready to go home.
Our tent was over there. And what a day, it's freezing, absolutely bitter today. Northerly wind, but what a view, look. Kirkfell, Great Gable, Ling Mill, over the back there's Scaffold Pike, Scarfell's up there.
So all that's left for me to say is have a very happy new year and lots of adventures. See you again.